Now we are going to discuss that is the anti-epileptic drug. Anti-epileptic drug. That is very important, anti-epileptic drug. See, anti-epileptic drug have total 5 classification. First one is increasing GABA. Now the second thing is decreasing glutamate. Now the third thing is T-type or T-gate calcium channel blocker. Fourth thing is sodium channel blocker. And the fifth thing is potassium channel opener. Here not blockers, potassium channel opener. We are going to use this 5 classification to control the seizure attacks or the episode that is epileptic. So this drug all are going to prevent the epileptic. That's why we call the condition anti-epileptic drug. Okay, now we are going to discuss the drug from the first classification, that all the drug will help to increase the GABA. Normally GABA get degenerated. So first I'm going to discuss the thing that is increasing the GABA level. First drug we are going to use, that is pregabalin, gabapentin. Pregabalin and gabapentin. So this drug will stimulate to production of, that is the main thing, mechanism of action, MOA, stimulate the production of the GABA. If the GABA stimulation will production happen, means what about the GABA level? Yeah, it will be increases. Now the latest information they can add, okay. Before that only stimulating the GABA. But these two drugs, what is the main mechanism? Means it will stimulate the GABA production by blocking the calcium channel. That is the new thing they are added in the textbook. You can see by blocking calcium. So first one pregabalin, second one gabapentin, third one vigabatrin. See, normally I told you GABA will go to degenerate, okay, by the help of the enzyme transaminase. So if I am going to stop the degeneration, means the GABA level will be increases. So by stopping the degeneration, I am going to inhibit the enzyme that help to form the degeneration, that is transaminase. So what is the main mechanism of this drug? Means it will inhibit the transaminase process, then it automatically GABA level will be increases. So from the drug you can understand, see, listen very carefully, I am writing here V GABA drink. Here I wrote V gabapentin. So TR transaminase, IR inhibitor, and GABA. So from the drug, from the word itself, you can understand the mechanism. So this drug we are going to use for maximum infantile seizure. Infantile seizure. So we can use this drug for infantile seizure, but in the questions, if they can ask what is the drug of choice for infantile seizure, you have to choose IV-ACTH, adrenal corticotropical hormone. So infantile seizure, that is the drug of choice. Drug of choice for infantile seizure, IV-ACTH. Now, for remembering only, I will give you some important keywords. ACTH, first thing we are going to use the treatment for infantile seizure. Next thing I am going to tell you, we can use this medicine for the disease, that is peripheral diabetes insipidus. Soon we will discuss diabetes mellitus upcoming videos. But peripheral diabetes insipidus, we can use this drug ACTH. We have central diabetes insipidus and the peripheral diabetes insipidus. Now infantile seizure. Now I am came here, fourth drug, tiagabine. Here just you can remember the GAT1 receptor. GAT1 receptor will be blocked. See, these all the drugs will help to increase the GABA. So now the GABA will be shifted to the another form. So by the GAT1 receptor. So if we block this receptor by using this drug, we can get increasing of the GABA. Next drug we are going to use, that is barbiturate. In barbiturate family, mainly we are going to use the drug phenobarbital. Now the next drug we are going to discuss, that is the benzodiazepam. That is sedative drug also, don't forget. Benzodiazepam, sedative drug also. In benzodiazepam groups, the drugs comes under diazepam, lorazepam, clonazepam, clozapam. So benzodiazepam, the family diazepam, lorazepam, clonazepam and clozapam. Diazepam, we can use a drug of size for febrile seizure. And then clonazepam we are using for the absent seizure. Then clozapam, we can use the linox, Gastaut syndrome. See, it's not very important to know about this syndrome. This is a very rare condition of the seizure. Just now remember, for linox Gastaut syndrome, we can use clozapam. This is the drugs we are studied to increase the GABA. Now we are moving to the next classification, that is decreasing the glutamate. Now the second thing we are going to study, decrease the glutamate. In that family, we have to remember just one thing. I am going to block the two receptor to decrease the glutamate. First thing is NMDA receptor. I'm going to inhibit the NMDA receptor. And the second thing is AMPA receptor. I'm going to inhibit the NMDA receptor to decreasing the glutamate. Here to inhibit the NMDA receptor, I'm using the drug felbamate. Next thing, to inhibit the AMPA receptor, I am using the drug perampanel. These the two drugs from the help to decrease the glutamate. Now we are going to move the third classification, that is T-type calcium channel blocker. We already studied correct calcium channel blocker, L-gate calcium channel blocker, and now we are studying the T-gated or T-type calcium channel blocker. T-type calcium channel blocker is ethosuximide. Before coming here, we can remember the main side effect of the felbamate, that is bone marrow suppression. And perampanel we can use for focal seizure or paralysis seizure. I already told in the previous video. So T-type calcium channel blocker, that is ethosuximide. For remembering, I can add you some point. The calcium channel blocker, dihydropyridone and non-dihydropyridone. Dihydropyridone, the drug, the end with the pine. Correct, we studied amylodipine, nicardipine, nimlodipine, everything comes under the dihydropyridine. Non-dihydropyridine, that is, we already studied our L-type calcium channel blocker, that is verampamil or diltiazem. This is for remembering only. Now T-type calcium channel blocker, that is ethosuximide. Ethosuximide we are using for the absent seizure. Now, third classification we finished.